Hello, my name is Eric Keller, and I am E&M's product specialist for Six Sensors based in the Pacific Northwest. In today's video, I would like to talk to you about the difference between incremental and absolute encoders. Before we dive into the difference between the two, let's review how an encoder works. An encoder, as seen here, takes the rotation of a shaft or a pulley or something spinning in this input shaft and turns it into a position, a speed, or a rotation. This signal is then picked up by a PLC or your control system and used for position feedback. So now, let's dive into the difference between the two. Incremental encoders are a common type of basic encoder. They're mostly used in applications where the speed of rotation is the most important information you're trying to gather. For example, they are commonly used in pumps, fans, conveyors, and other applications where it's important to know speed but not position. Here's how they work. Inside the encoder is a light emitter and receiver, as well as a rotating disc with many little slots cut into it. These slots determine the minimum resolution of the encoder. As light passes through and is blocked by the slots in the disc, the encoder knows how far the disc is turned. Every time the light receiver receives a new pulse of light through the disc, it knows the encoder has moved a very small amount. The encoder gives pulsed output based on every increment of movement or resolution. How fine a movement is indicated by the pulses per revolution, or how many times the encoder can split one revolution of the shaft turning. You may have noticed as the encoder turns that we're seeing three different signals. These signals are called channels. These channels are used to determine the direction of the movement as well as for counting revolutions. The two square wave channels are the A and B channel. These channels are offset to each other, and this is required so we can tell when the encoder is moving in one direction or another. This is important when trying to use the encoder for positioning. The third channel, called the Z or marker channel, is used to determine number of revolutions in the encoder. This is the zero or home position on the encoder wheel. This channel is only turned on once per revolution, and it can be used to home the encoder in case of a power cycle. If the marker or the home position is placed exactly at the homing position of the movement, it can be used to count revolutions and give relative determination of position. SICK encoders also have additional inverse channels standard on all incremental encoders to help filter out noise and increase reliability. The downfall to an incremental encoder is that there is no way to determine absolute position since it is just measuring incremental movements. For example, say this encoder was powered off. When the system came back on, there is no address or indication of where the encoder disk is in its rotation. This means that the zero or home position is lost when power is switched off, and it must be reset when the encoder is powered back up. Absolute encoders solve the problem of losing its position during a power reset by having more data on the internal encoder wheel that indicates the precise location. Just like the incremental encoder, the absolute encoder is comprised of a light emitter and receiver, as well as a rotating disc with many little slots cut into it. You'll notice that the disc looks a bit different, and that is because it now has multiple rings of varying light paths. These light paths or tracks are all monitored individually like individual incremental encoders. At every position of movement on the encoder, these rings are uniquely lit up on the receiver, creating an address. This unique address is critical in knowing the exact position of the encoder. The benefit of knowing these addresses on the encoder is that in the case of a power reset, the home position is not lost. When the encoder powers back up, the light allowed through the disc will always create the same address as it had before the power loss. The encoder is no longer just counting pulses up or down from its home position. It is always knowing exactly where the disc is. The output of the encoder is no longer up to six channels with square wave pulses to indicate change of position and direction. The output of the absolute encoder is a unique address or position the encoder sees. Counting direction is very easy with the absolute encoder because all you have to do is watch as the address is building upward or falling downward. Another type of absolute encoder is called a multi-turn encoder. Multi-turn absolute encoders can give you long runs of distance without the encoder turning over to zero. The downfall to a traditional single turn absolute encoder is that the encoder itself will reset its address to zero after one revolution of the encoder shaft. This can be problematic for applications with long linear runs without a gear reduction between the linear movement and the encoder, or if extremely precise movement is required where a gear reduction cannot be used. A multi-turn encoder was created to solve this problem. A multi-turn encoder has a built-in geared drivetrain, which allows the encoder to be used on long, precise linear movements. The geared drivetrain works by combining the unique address of the encoder itself with an additional address from the four gears in the drivetrain, where the gears in the drivetrain monitor the number of turns of the encoder shaft. In essence, the drivetrain records how many times the encoder shaft has turned, giving you up to 12 bits of numbers of rotations, effectively meaning an absolute encoder shaft can spin 4,096 times before resetting to zero. Now that we understand the fundamental difference between an incremental and an absolute encoder, let's discuss a couple applications where each of these might be used. First, the incremental encoder. The incremental encoder is used when position does not matter. So you will find this on conveyors, fans, and pumps. The conveyor uses this data from the incremental encoder to tell how fast the conveyor is moving, or to tell how far the belt has run. The true position does not matter. You only care that the belt has moved 2 feet, for example, or that you're spinning your pump or your fan at 20 RPM or at 25 miles per hour. The absolute encoder comes into play when position is truly critical. Since the absolute encoder does not lose its actual position when the power is reset, you do not have to do a homing feature. So you will find these types of encoders on robotic arms, gantry cranes, or anything that is moving something where position is absolutely critical. If you have any more questions about incremental versus absolute encoders, please feel free to reach out to your local SICK product specialist and we would be happy to help you. Thanks and have a great day.